Power prices set to go up in October as the government approves Meralco's rate adjustment. The Energy Regulatory Commission says the increase is mainly due to the dwindling natural gas supply of the Malampaya, as well as higher import costs of liquefied natural gas. The agency projects a rate hike at 33 centavos per kilowatt hour, which would reflect on the generation charge of Meralco customers. This means households consuming 200 kilowatts per hour can expect an additional 66 pesos in their bill per month. Meralco, however, said it has yet to do final computations, but it also said it would inform the ERC and the public on the actual impact of the order on its power rates. Thailand's parliament elects the country's youngest ever prime minister. 37-year-old Prithongtan Sinawat won with 319 votes, or nearly two-thirds of the House. The political neophyte is the daughter of former leader Thaksin Shinawat. Her selection comes just 2 days after former Prime Minister Tretta Thavisin was dismissed by a constitutional court. Prithongtan now faces the difficult task of reviving Thailand's stalled economy and avoiding military coups which have deposed four previous administrations.
Philippine Senator Ronald De La Rosa claims the Marcos administration is working with leftist groups and so-called yellows to pin down former President Rodrigo Duterte and his allies. Yellows refer to supporters or those associated with the Liberal Party. De La Rosa believes these groups are conspiring to destroy the Duterte camp. The senator, however, admits he does not know if President Marcos is aware or is behind this alliance. De La Rosa named National Intelligence Coordinating Agency Director General Ricardo De Leon and former Senator Antonio Trillanes as among those who are working against the Dutertes. De Leon has denied the allegation. De La Rosa cited the attack on the intelligence funds of the Office of the Vice President and the Education Department when Duterte was the secretary as one instance where the supposed alliance worked. ANC has reached out to the palace for the comment.
As early as now, gigibain nila si Vice President Inday Sara para to secure the presidency for themselves. Gigibain nila yung Duterte camp, the Dutertes including their allies. Gigibain na ninyo para lang ma-secure ninyo yung presidency for the 2028. Very dirty politics. Very dirty. At isipin mo, there seems to be, and I really can feel it, that there is an alliance with this government and yung mga makakaliwa at saka yung mga yellow. Nagkasama-sama na sila to pin down the Duterte people. So it pains me a lot.
Philippine Vice President Sara Duterte says she is ready to take a drug test following a proposed measure to randomly test all government officials. Her brother, Davao Congressman Paolo Duterte, recently filed a bill seeking to mandate random drug tests on all officials, including the president. The vice president says they're making preparations for her drug test that will involve a third party and multiple laboratories for a credible result.